Dr. Rohit Om Prakash, who will try to defend why he would have first allowed his mom to get a brown cataract and then why he's choosing FACO to do it.
Yeah, brown cataract FACO emulsification in my own mother. Well, we cannot have a debate without involving the audience also. Well, I have access to all techniques in my institute. That's the first point. My indications for FLAX is not a brown cataract. Well, as has already been told, the advantages of FLAX in brown cataracts are achieving appropriate CCC, initiation of cleavage planes, softening. Yes, definitely yes. How many in the audience have FLAX? Can you raise hands? Not the speakers, the audience. Hardly anybody. How many are not doing brown cataracts? Practically everybody. So there's only one person. How many of us would like to get SICS done in brown cataract for the mother? Three, four, five. For your mother. For your mother, SICS. Yeah. I'm talking about the real brown ones, not the other browns. And how many are referring brown cataracts? Hardly anybody. So where does FACO go wrong in black cataracts? Because there's difficult nuclear disassembly, more disposed to collateral damage of PCR, corneal endothelial trauma, all these things. Let's see this video. This is a jet black cataract for all purposes. What are the things which need to be done? Longitudinal FACO, deep into it, and the first problem was, creating initial planes, initial cleavage planes. This can be achieved if you do it rightly. Use the chopper of choice. As you can see in this case, it's a heart. It's a pointed chopper, 1.5 or 1.75. The most important thing is how you hold it. So holding will done. Then horses for courses. See the chopper I have changed. And you can have adequate cleavage planes whatsoever without any issue using now not the longitudinal FACO, but the Ozil one for this matter. You can see how adequately it has been separated. Next is how to take care of the endothelium. See the chopper scaffold, which I'm using. See how the chopper is being taken around, all around, so that no nucleus piece touches the endothelium. Dr. Mahipal was talking about clear corneas. I'll show you what clear corneas are in this black cataract. Working at a deeper plane, using visco again, because at all times you have to protect the endothelium. The chamber is adequately deep now. CD, no doubt, is 26. You see how the chopper scaffold is working. You are keeping the nucleus piece away from the endothelium. Here the technique matters, not the things like FLAX which will matter, because ultimately you have to protect the endothelium. Now once that is done, you will find that the last piece also is being managed with high fluidics, with the chamber adequately and the bag taken care of by the visco. See the clear cornea on right on the POD1. This is what it is. So there's hardly any. So it has to be a two-step FACO emulsification, as I've already talked about. Different FACO modes for different steps. No need to be disheartened. Before anything else, preparation is the key to success. So my technique of choice in brown cataracts happens to be FACO emulsification. Indication for FLAX in brown cataracts are only when there is extreme generalized zonulopathy with shallow AC with pupil not dilating well. My surgical satisfaction and day is consistently made by smartly conquering brown cataracts day in and day out. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thanks, Dr. Rohit, for nicely elucidating that. And now we'll take a quick audience poll, okay? Your mom has brown cataract and you want to refer them. You have a choice of sending to any of the top surgeons. You have Femto, you have SICS, and you have FACO. How many people would want to refer their mom for SICS to Dr. Gogate? Nobody? My God. Parikshit. That's terrible. Okay. You can convince them. That means how many people would like to refer to Dr. Rohit for FACO in a brown cataract? 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. And how many people would like to refer their mother for FLAX-assisted cataract surgery? Okay, so I think FACO wins, it seems, yeah. But personally, I would think that brown cataract is a great indication if you have Femto.
Yeah, if you have. But then, you need not, if you have the right technique, right tissue respect, It's not.
So I think it's right. I mean, you know, if you have both, I would obviously choose Flex. Yeah. You know, why would I do phaco when it would take more time and more corneal trauma and everything? You know, femto can cleave the brown cataracts very nicely, and it's one of my peak indications for doing femto. Yet, if I don't have femto, there's nothing to lose. I mean, phaco is still a great technique, and SICS is wonderful too. I mean, full marks to SICS, it protects. Anyway.